going to Pop Quiz, and two skippers who've both won Pop Quiz rounds before. Firstly, Dave Edmund's team, and they are Maggie Bell, who's currently storming up the American charts with Bobby Whitlock. And a welcome return from the drummer with the Pretenders, Martin Chambers. And the only Welshman in the squad trying to win for a second time, Dave Edmunds. And they are facing the might of Jake Byrne's team, and Jake has already skippered two winning teams going for his hat-trick tonight. And his team comprised from Queen, John Deacon, and from Spandau Ballet, currently topping the charts, Martin Kemp. And will he be the first to do three in a row? Skipper Jake Byrnes. Round one is an individual round. It's to do with themes from television programs. So I'd like you to identify the piece of music, name the artist, and tell me the program that it has as its theme. John, you're first. Listen to this. What was it?
Eye Level?
It was?
Yes.
By the... Do you remember who it was by?
Simon Park Orchestra.
Do you remember the TV series?
No idea, I've never seen it.
It was from Vandervolk. Oh. But I'll give you two, because you're most of the way there. Well done. Maggie Bell, it's your turn. Who is this?
Clannad.
That's right, and it was...
Harry's Game.
Theme from Harry's Game. Another 2 points. Jake, here's one for you.
It's the thing from Hill Street Blues. Is it Larry Post?
It's close. You've got the names...
Carlton, then. Larry Carlton.
Larry Carlton, and it was...
Who's the other Lamppost.
I don't know.
What
Mike
do you got most...
Post. Mike Post.
Mike Post, yes, absolutely. 2 points. Well done. Dave Edmunds, TV theme coming up for you. Theme from?
Lord George.
Lord George, yes. Lord George.
Key Mire.
Key Mire. Do you know who it was by?
Haven't the faintest idea.
Do you think it was by Ennio Morricone?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. Can you spell it?
E.
I'll give you 2 points anyway for attempting it. Martin Kemp, one coming up for you. You know the TV
Old Grey
show?
Whistle Test.
Yeah. Old Grey Whistle Test.
I haven't got a clue.
I'll give you 1 point for the Old Grey Whistle Test. It was Area Code 615 and Stone Fox Chase.
What's that?
1 point out of a possible two. Martin Chambers, finally in the round one for you. Any ideas who that
was? First of all, I'd like to say that I was under the impression I was asked to appear on Question of Sport. Because I don't know anything about music, you see. Well, what I'll say to this is it Weekend World or something like that?
Yes, it is Weekend World.
Right.
You're right. Right. So you know more than
By
you
Ray Reardon and the Rear End? Mountain, maybe.
It's Mountain, yes. Do you know what it's called?
I don't know.
It's
Little
called,
Hill?
It's Taunter, Sammy's tune. But I'll give you the 2 points because you got most of the way there.
Thank you.
Plus
very
a good
much.
Gag. The end of round one. The scores, Jake Byrne's team 5, Dave Edmunds' team 6. Right, round two is a team question. Dave, your team to go first. Question coming up in a moment. First of all, is Don and Phil, the Everly Brothers.
I want you to tell me why you walk out on me. Thank you. same old way. Think about the love that burns within my heart for you. The good times we had before you went away. Oh, me. Walk right back to me this minute. Bring your love to me, don't send it. I'm so lonesome every day.
Great stuff. The Everly Brothers. Can you name their four chart-topping hits, their four number ones?
Well, as Dream, definitely.
All I Have to Do is Dream, yes.
All I Have to Do is Dream. Is it, I don't know, Walk Right Back?
Walk Right Back's two.
It's written by Sonny Curtis.
That's right. No bonus points for that, but two more to get.
Two more number ones.
Mm-hmm.
Kathy's Clown.
That was one.
Temptation?
A Temptation, absolutely. Well done. So a full 5 points to Dave Edmund's team there. Jake, to you and some film from the Beatles from 1963 and a record which has just gone back into the charts. And From Me to You, which has just gone back into the charts again. How many solo Beatle albums can you name?
All Things Must Pass, Sentimental Journey, Ram, does Band on the Run count? Imagine, Walls and Bridges.
Give me one more.
Wings at the Speed of Sound.
Absolutely, fantastic. 5 points. The end of round two, still 1 point in it. Jake Burns' team 10, Dave Edmund's team 11. Into the much-loved lyric round. John, you're first, I'm afraid. Here comes your lyric. Spilling up pink silk and coffee lace, you hook me up and rendezvous at your place.
No, I must have been in Venezuela or somewhere when it was released.
You were in Epping.
You'll be in Cloud Cuckoo Land when you hear this.
Spilling up pink silk and coffee lace.
All My Heart by ABC, so nothing there. Maggie, where do these lines come from? Woman, oh woman, don't treat me so mean. You're the meanest old woman that I've ever seen.
Hit the road, Jack.
Go on, give me a bit more, go on.
No more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack.
Who is it by?
Richard.
Oh, 2 points for you. Well done and well sung as well.
Thank you.
Right, Jake, a recent hit for you. I don't know which side I'm on. I don't know my right from left or my right from wrong.
Two Hearts Beat as One, You Two.
You Two, and Two Hearts Beat as One. Well done. Next, it's Skipper Dave Edmunds. Where have we taken these lines from? Venus was a beautiful lass. She
Brown
had the world.
Handsome man, Chuck Berry.
Even faster than Jake, eh? Whoa! Martin Kemp, lyric coming up for you. I won't laugh at you when you boo hoo hoo.
Oh, it must have been a holiday boom, wasn't it?
Venezuela must have been pretty packed, I guess, at the time.
I won't laugh at you when you boo hoo hoo.
Laugh at you when you boo hoo hoo. Because I love you.
There you go, Slade, and Cos, I love you. Finally, in this round, the other Martin, here's yours. It winds from Chicago to LA, more than 2,000 miles all the way.
Route 66?
Route 66 it is. The end of round three, Jake Burns' team has 12 and 5 points ahead with 17, Dave Edmund's team. The next rounds for both teams, 10 tracks, all with eyes in the title. And I'd like you to list, please, the artists only, and here come the tracks. How many did you get?
The Eagles, Dr. Hook, David Soul, Art Garfunkel, Frankie Valli, Crystal Gill, The Eagles, Kate Bush, Roxy Music, and Jimi Hendrix.
Dave, but give me yours just in case some of
the
those
Eagles,
are wrong.
The Eagles, Dr. Hook, David Soul, Art Garfunkel, Frankie Valli, Crystal Gill.
Eagles.
Eagles.
Yeah.
Kate Bush, Roxy Music, Jimi Hendrix.
Absolutely right. You have both 10 out of 10. And the tracks for Black Skin, Blue Eye Boys, Sexy Eyes, Going In With My Eyes Open, Bright Eyes, My Eyes Adored You, Don't It Make My Brown Eyes Blue, Lying Eyes, Man With A Child In His Eyes, Angel Eyes, and Gypsy Eyes. So Jake Burns' team, 22, and still 5 in the lead, Dave Edmund's team with 27. Right, another individual round, no conferring. Ladies first, Maggie, question for you about Aretha Franklin. First of all, a bit of archive Aretha. Great singer, eh, Maggie? Which track on the Aretha Franklin album, Lady Soul, won her 2 Grammy Awards?
Respect.
Respect, absolutely. And for 2 points for that, for a bonus point, another track on the album, Good to Me as I Am to You, featured a famous guitarist. Do you know who he was?
Eric Clapton.
Eric Clapton, yes, bonus point as well. Great stuff. John Deacon, chance for you to shine. First of all, a clip for you of a very young Billy Preston. Right.
Yeah.
Song.
What's the question?
A song made famous by the Rolling Stones. Billy Preston also featured on 2 hit singles by the Beatles. Do you know what they were? One in 69, one in 70.
Hmm? Not today, I don't know.
One in 69, one in 70.
Possibly Get Back.
Get Back was one of them. Yeah. What do you think the other one would possibly be? Or
Something with an organ in it. No idea, sorry.
No, you can't, I'm sorry. They don't even deserve a point because I saw the piece of paper pass between you. The one that Jake didn't know was Let It Be. For a further point, what was Billy Preston's only UK hit as a solo artist?
That's the Way God Planned It.
Absolutely, bonus point, well done. See, only a few things escape my eye. Over to Dave Edmunds now. A clip for you, Dave, of The Beach Boys.
A boy and a girl, they once found love. Two inches seemed like heaven above. He looked into her eyes and said, "When we baby, you're so good for my head."
The Beach Boys have had 2 number one hits in this country, Dave. Can you name them? Not the Beach Boys, the Number Ones.
Yeah. Oh, well, Good Vibrations was one, which I thought was their only number one. I'm going to take a guess.
The other one was not so obvious.
Do It Again.
Do It Again, you're absolutely right, yes. Yeah. Tell you what, I'll give you a bonus point for naming the original lineup.
The original lineup? You mean with Glen Campbell and all that?
No, the original well-known Beach Boys lineup.
Well, the three brothers.
Dennis, Carl,
Brian.
Yes.
Bruce Johnson, of course, wasn't in the original lineup.
Their cousin was.
So it was Al Jardine.
Al Jardine and...
And Mike Love.
Their cousin Mike Love, absolutely. Well done. Bonus point. Jake, your question is about Tom Petty. For you, an extract from a recent concert of his.
You know, I still remember you used to be the 9 years old. I went to school for you, babe, but I'm not gonna let you know.
Tom Petty. Jake, which Tom Petty song was written as a tribute to the Byrds? And Jim McGinn later covered it.
American Girl.
When he became Roger McGinn. American Girl. Well done, he has 2 points. And a bonus point if you can tell me Tom Petty's only British top 40 hit.
This is a guess. Here Comes My Girl?
No. Anything that's rock and roll. Have your points for the other bit. Martin Chambers for you, a film clip of Ian Hunter and Mott the Hoople. Great band, Mott the Hoople. How many of their other top 20 hits can you name?
All the Young Dudes was the biggest one.
Right.
That got to about number two. Right. I think their first single that didn't do much at all was Downtown. All the Way From Memphis.
Right. One more.
You could have Golden Age of Rock and Roll. Or you could have Roll Away the Stone.
Roll Away the Stone. I would accept 2 points, yes. Finally, in this round, Martin Kemp, some Clash for you. Here's a video of them. You're the prophet. Find out who gets sound. Degenerate the faithful with that crazy Casbah sound. The pedal when they brought out the electric cat drum. The local guitar picking cops keep talking from. As soon as the sheriff cleared the square. Right, for 1 point, Martin, can you name the three permanent members of The Clash?
Paul Simonon, Joe Strummer and Mick Jones.
Absolutely right. That's for 1 point. Can you name their longest serving drummer?
Is it Terry Chimes?
No.
Mick Topper.
Topper.
Topper Heaton.
Right, absolutely right. Another point for that. The end of round five. Jake Burns' team, 28. Dave Edmund's team in front with 35. The quickfire round, fingers on the buzzers, 2 points for a right answer, 1 point if I throw it over to somebody else. Right, so fingers on the buzzers. Whose current album is called The Key? Yes, Jake.
Joan Armatrading.
Joan Armatrading, 2 points. Who had a hit with Video Killed the Radio Star? Yes, Martin.
Buggles.
Buggles, 2 points. Which member of Buggles has produced hits for Dollar and ABC? Martin.
Trevor Horn,
2 points. ABC was a hit for which group in 1970? Yes, Jake.
Jackson 5.
Jackson 5, 2 points. What was the first single taken from Michael Jackson's Thriller album? Yes, John.
Billie Jean.
Sorry. No, it wasn't. 1 point to somebody else. No, it wasn't. Anybody else?
Beat It?
No.
The first single taken from Michael Jackson's Thriller album was The Girl Is Mine, Paul McCartney. Which band featured Paul McCartney's brother? Which band featured Martin?
Scaffold.
The Scaffold, yes. He was Mike McGear. What was their only number one? Jake.
Lily the Pink.
Lily the Pink, yes. Name Kissing the Pink's current hit. Jake.
Last film.
The last film, 2 points. Who wrote the soundtrack for the film Local Hero? Yes, Martin.
Mark Knopfler.
Mark Knopfler did, 2 points. Studio. Listen to this.
I'm going down in Louisiana to get me a mojo. I'm going down in Louisiana to
okay, get me a mojo. Who is it? Yes, Dave.
Muddy Waters.
Muddy Waters, yes, who died last weekend. Named last year's hit for Rocker's Revenge. Anybody? Yes, Martin.
Walking on Sunshine.
Walking on Sunshine, 2 points. Who wrote Walking on Sunshine? Martin and Martin have come up together. That's who wrote
impossible.
It?
Is it Eddie Grant? Eddie Grant.
Yeah, 1 point each. Very well done. And finally, who were close to the edge in 1972? Yes, Jake.
Yes.
Yes, 2 points. The final scores. He was going with three in a row. Ah. Jake Burns' team, 43. Dave Edmund's team, 44. Oh, dear. Neck and neck at the end there. We'd like to thank, first of all, Jake Burns' team, and they are from Queen, John Deacon. From Spandau Ballet, Martin Kemp. And no doubt he'll be back for another go in the next series, Jake Burns. But it was so close, although they were pipped by the might of Maggie Bell. Yay! Martin Chambers. Yay! And the triumphant skipper for the second time, Dave Edmund. Yay! I'll be back at a later time of 6:50 next week with Pop Quiz, when the teams will be captained by Queen's Roger Taylor. And his team will be John Martin and Stephen Luscombe from Blancmange. And they'll be taking on Hank Marvin's team, who will be Susie Quattro, Nick Lowe, and, of course, Hank. Leave you this week with The Who from 1969, and I Can See for Miles. And we'll see you next week at 6:50.
Nerve to say that you still want me.
Well, that says maybe, but you gotta stand trial. Good comes all the while.
Pick somebody who's like a favourite of mine for a number of years, and funnily enough, they've never done national TV in this country before. They've done a couple of local things, but they've never been on national TV, which seemed to me to be shocking. Mm.